Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. So today's video is going to be one that's been very long overdue. This is about Crystal Focus 10 or CFX blade styles and blade profiles. So if you have a Profi Saber, if you have an Asteria Saber, if you have a Golden Harvest V3 Saber, anything like that, this video does not apply to you. This is solely for Crystal Focus 10 Sabers. So you know, Saber Trio Sabers, Vader's Vault Sabers, Genesis Custom Sabers, a custom install with Crystal Focus 10, those sabers. It has to have a Crystal Focus 10 soundboard so you can apply the knowledge shown in this video to your soundboard. This will not apply for Profi, so not apply for Asteria, anything like that. It's totally different for every other soundboard. So a lot of people have asked me over the, 7 months or so since I started this channel about, Crystal Focus 10 blade profiles and Crystal Focus 10 blade styles. So if you don't know, Crystal Focus 10 was created by Irv Plechter of Plechter Labs, and it's not an open source board. Now, that being said, you can take the parameters of a blade style and a blade profile and like tweak a bunch of things and like make it your own. So in that sense, people can consider it open source, but it's not open source in the same way that Profi is or anything like that, or a real open source board. You have to wait for Plechter Labs to release updates to, achieve certain blade styles and blade effects and all that kind of stuff. On Profi, you can kind of make whatever you want, but Crystal Focus 10, you're kind of locked to what they have available at the time of when you're actually doing stuff. I mean, you have to wait for updates to have certain effects and all that kind of stuff unlocked, really. So Crystal Focus 10 is a little bit locked, which means that you either have to create your own blade style or you can, use other people's blade styles. Now, luckily, I had someone reach out to me about this a while back. And I can't remember who it was, and I can't remember where you reached out to me at. I don't know if it was in a YouTube comment. I don't know if it was on Twitch. I don't know if it was on Instagram. I don't know if it was an email. I can't find that message, but someone reached out to me a while back about something called crystalfocus.net, which is not directly associated with Plechter Labs. So this isn't, owned by Irv Plechter or anything like that. This is owned by some fans, some Saber enthusiasts. And what this is a site that has a bunch of, blade styles and configurators and all that kind of stuff, so you can do your own blade styles. Now, this isn't the only, blade styles on the market. I mean, this has, 70, 80, something like that. There are definitely other blade styles out there, which I'll get into right now. So if you Google CFX blade styles, the first thing will come up is this post on Reddit, and it'll be, somebody asking about blade styles. And then Pirate Greenbeard, Nick, he shared some of his blade styles. This is from 10 months ago, but the blade styles still work. So, here's a spreadsheet of his profiles, original trilogy, sequel trilogy, prequel trilogy. I use some of these in my Saber. He's got, 31 or so, 30 blade styles right here. And he's really good. So to get those blade styles, here's the config file. So you just use this, you can go to, if you want, stripes, then that's number 22. You go to config.txt, go to profile 22 right here. You copy and paste this entire piece right here, everything under profile 22 and then before profile 23. And then all you do is you add that to your config file on your Saber, but you have to rename this profile to whatever is directly after what you already have. So if you have 7 blade profiles already on your config file, then you need to name this 8. So that's just something to keep in mind. I've gone over this before in a video, but I feel the need to reiterate it. Nick also has, colors that you can use, like 30 colors, and the colors file, so you can copy the colors into your colors.txt, which is very helpful. So I'll leave a link to that Reddit post and Nick's stuff in the description below, so you can find those. So the other one I wanted to talk about was crystalfocus.net. So what this is, it's run by Tristan. I think this is Tristan Cam from my one of my YouTube subscribers, actually. And they have, these different sections of the website: blade profile, CFX parameters, CFX configurator. This is kind of like a state-of-the-art configurator that's not up and running yet, but that'll probably be really interesting if you have Crystal Focus and Saber in the future once they release that. So let's just look at blade profiles. So, it starts at 3. I don't know what happened to 1 and 2, but it starts at 3. They have all kinds of, blade styles. It has 12 pages of them. So let's just take a look at one of them. You see this unstable energy blade. Let's just go to another one. Unstable fading colors. So it looks pretty cool. There's all kinds of blade styles here. So Tristan wasn't the one that, made all these blade styles. So you can see, credit to Robert Sotomayor, credit to, there were other ones from, I believe, Stephen Powell here. Stephen Powell from Powell's Power Ups. There's a lot of blade styles in here that he just compiled into one site, which is very helpful because looking for blade styles and having to go, message someone on Facebook for their blade style, that kind of sucks. Unless that's, the way they want to do it. But I mean, there are all kinds of blade styles. This one's from Mark Davidson, Paul Smith. And there are all kinds of blade styles that you can use. So let's just take a look at one. Let's do a pretty simple one that I'll use for a blade style that we can take a look at for one of my fonts, and we'll add it to the Saber, and I'll show you how to do that. So the first thing you want to do, take your SD card out of your Crystal Focus 10 Saber, and you're going to put it in to your computer. I'm going to be using a micro SD card reader, and I'm going to put it in my computer, and I'll show you how. So just using, one of these things. I've shown this before on the video, so this is nothing new. You're gonna put that micro SD card. You're gonna put it in the computer. It's gonna say Saber Trio or something, whatever you named it, and then you're gonna go to it. So you see, I have 56 sound fonts. All right, so what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to config. I have probably 15 or 16 blade profiles. Let's see, 15. It says profile 15, but it starts at 0, so it's actually 16 blade profiles. So let's say I want to add one, and I have this OB4 sound font downloaded from Kyberphonic that I'll show you how to do the whole process. So let's say I want this one, just light flickering. It's a very basic one. I already have something like this, but I'm going to show you how to do it anyway. So light flickering blade profile. As you can see here, it has all the parameters that you need. And you're just going to copy and paste the entire thing into your config. Okay, but you need to name it. So let's just copy this so you can have the format down. I'm going to name this profile 16. And I'm gonna just name this, what do we call it here? Light flickering. Have to put two slashes in front of it so that it'll work if you want to name your profiles. You can just have it, just profile 16, but I like to name them so I know which blade profile it is. So once you've added that, you can go and adjust, the style lockup, style flicker, style blaster, all that kind of stuff. I've shown how to do that in other videos. So once you do that, then you just hit save. Just remember that this is profile 16. So next thing we're going to do is this. So I have this OB4 sound font from Kyberphonic, OB4 CFX. As you can see here, font config, that's something you need. Kyberphonic does not include an LED stat text. So what you need to do is on a sound font that you already have installed on your Saber that you know it works. So let's just pick one. So you're going to go to LEDs in some folder that you already have. You're going to copy it. And then you're going to paste it into this folder. And now you can see LEDs in there. So the font config on OB4, start blade, start color. I've already shown everyone how to do this stuff in the past, but I have to reiterate it every time because some people don't get it. So start blade, start color. If you have it set to -1, that means when you change the blade profile in spectrum mode, when the Saber is on and you set it to something, it'll stay what you set it. Now, start underscore color, same thing. It'll probably start off as green when you turn the Saber on. And then when you go to spectrum mode and you change it to, blue, red, whatever, it'll stay that color until you change it again. Or if you come in this font config and you change it. So start underscore blade, that pertains to blade profile. Start underscore color, obviously, that pertains to blade color. So start underscore blade, remember the one I just did, the one I just copied off of crystalfocus.net was number 16. I added that to my blade profiles in my config. So start underscore blade 16. I'm gonna actually go to this. This is Negotiator. This is like a prequel Obi-Wan Kenobi sound font. So I'm actually going to copy the blade timings on this one exactly because it's, you know, just how I like it. So I'm going to copy the blade timings and I'm going to add it in. There we go. Now, once you got this, this is the font config for OB4, which is the new font I'm adding in. Start underscore color. We can actually change it to what's in here. My color is 11, but what I actually want to do is I want to change the color a little bit because the Negotiators has, you know, like a royal blue, which is kind of what you see in the prequels for Obi-Wan. But in the original trilogy, OB4 in A New Hope, his is a little bit more like cyan type color. So I'm going to go to colors. These are my colors: royal blue, ice blue, light blue, and cyan. So I'm actually going to use cyan. Cyan is color number 13. So start underscore color. Number 13, and I'm going to save it. Once you have that saved, pretty much ready to go. This is OB4 CFX. So you can see here you have all the force sounds, blaster sounds. You have a track. This is probably the track from A New Hope when you first see Obi-Wan, but I could be wrong. This sound font is ready to go. So I'm going to just drag this out. This is something people need to realize. When you buy a sound font from a font maker, usually it'll come in a folder. So you'll get this folder, you'll download it from the Dropbox link that you get. Get the folder and it says, you know, OB4 Profi, OB4 Verso, OB4 CFX. If you just try to load this folder, the one that you downloaded directly from Dropbox on your Saber, it will not work, I promise you, because it has three different soundboards folders in the folder. So it's not going to work. So you have to drag the one that you're putting onto your sound font out of that folder or copy the files in that, make a new folder or something, and then put that directly onto the Saber. And this, all of this stuff has to be in the root directory of that folder. Otherwise, it will not work. Trust me. So, OB4 CFX. This one's ready to go. So, I'm going to go back to my Saber Trio. This is my SD card, my micro SD card. And I'm going to add this. And I'm going to just add this to the very end. So, it has to be 57-. And then you go, okay, so there we go. So 57 OB4 CFX. So now I will eject my micro SD card and I'll put it back in the Saber and I'll show you that now it is working.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
All right, so I reached it.
I'm Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Obi-Wan Kenobi. It may be hard to see because it is only a light flicker. You can kind of see it on the background. Alright. So now we got that working, let's do another one. So once again, we're going to take the micro SD card out of the Saber and we're going to put it back into the computer with a micro SD card reader. And I'm going to go back to crystalfocus.net and I'm going to use, you know, another blade style that, you know, I haven't used or something. All right. So this next font that we're going to use is called Piece of Junk by Kyberphonic. It comes in CFX, Profi, and Verso, like I've said. So once again, what we need to do is we need to make sure this sound font is, you know, optimized. So you got to make sure it has an LEDs.txt because Kyberphonic doesn't include that. So you just go to a sound font that already has one. Copy the LEDs.txt, and then you're going to go to the CFX folder, and you're going to paste that in there. Now you can see LEDs.txt. So, font config for this one, we're going to actually use one that's optimized for the Millennium Falcon. I think it's on the last page. Yes, right here. There we go. So, view parameters, this one is from Mark Davidson. So we're going to copy this blade profile. Copy. And then we're going to go back to the config folder for the Saber. Config. Go all the way down. And then you're going to copy and paste it. And then you're going to make sure you copy the correct parameters. And this will be profile 17. I'm going to go back and then I'm going to call it, you know, I'm going to call it Falcon just cause. All right. So that's blade profile 17 file. save, and then the config file with the blade profile is ready to go. Now we just need to make sure that we put the sound font on the Saber and that we put the blade profile into the font config folder. So we're going to do that now. So this is the Saber Trio folder. This is the micro SD card, piece of junk CFX. Let's take that out. Okay. And then you're going to drag this into the micro SD card folder. Just name this one 58. And by the way, I've had people ask me how many sound fonts you can have on a Crystal Focus 10. It is basically limitless as long as you have a micro SD card that can hold all the sound fonts. So this is a 16 gigabyte micro SD card. And from what I understand, so let's see. Use the space, 4.19 gigabytes, free space, 10.6 gigabytes. And I have 58 fonts on it. And I've done 1/4 of all of the sound fonts that I can hold on this Saber. So that's just something to keep in mind. You can put, you know, whatever 4 times 58 is, and that's pretty much how much that can fit on my SD card. Now you can get a 32 gigabyte SD card and you can have 8 times the amount of sound fonts that I have. You can get a 64 gigabyte and you can have, you know, however many sound fonts you want. 16 gigabytes is kind of the sweet spot. So you can hold a ton of fonts on a 16 gigabyte SD card. So piece of junk CFX. We're going to go to the font config file. So this is one that I honestly have no idea how to configure because it's a Millennium Falcon sound font. So the start blade, we know that one's going to be 17 because that's the Falcon blade profile that we added to our config file. The start color, this is something that I'm going to go back to this because they added a color profile here. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to go back to, I'm going to save this real quick before I forget. And then I'm going to go to the colors.txt of my Saber. I'm going to add it to the end. So I'm going to just call this, I have no idea what color this is, so I'm going to just call it Falcon again. Make sure you put 2 slashes. Okay, so that is color number 17. So it just so happens that it's going to work out that I'm going to use both color 17 and profile number 17. And, oh wait, let me change this to 7. Save. All right, so we're going to use blade profile 17, and we're going to use color number 17. So you go to your font config. 17. I have no idea what to do with the blade timings because it doesn't include them. So I'm not exactly sure how to do this, because it's a totally different type of blade style. So we're just going to roll with it and see how it works. All right, so make sure you save config file and eject the micro SD card, put it back in Saber, and we'll take a look. All right. As you can see, it kind of has that effect that you see when the Millennium Falcon is going into, you know, hyperdrive. All right, so that one works pretty well. So as you can see, Crystal Focus 10 blade profiles are really as simple as that. There's really not a whole lot to it. It's just kind of copy and paste. The same kind of applies for Prophy, but definitely not the same way. Prophy is a bit more difficult. And remember, this video does not apply to Prophy. This is only Crystal Focus 10. So if you enjoy the video, if you got something from this video, please leave a like, subscribe. I will leave the links to both Nick Pirate Greenbeard's blade profiles in the description below. I'll leave a link to crystalfocus.net in the description below so you can take a look at those if you have a Crystal Focus 10 Saber. So if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, subscribe, and may the force be with you.